The NFL draft is coming up on Thursday, April 29th in Cleveland, Ohio. One of the prospects looking to hear his name called during the course of that weekend joins me now, Justin Hilliard from Ohio State. Justin, how are you, man? How's the process been for you?
What's going on, man? It's been going well. It's honestly been a long process. You know, I feel like we played our last game like 8 months ago. But yeah, obviously it's the draft is coming up and yeah, so excited.
Now, I want you to take me back a little bit to when you first got started playing football. Just what was it that really drew you to the game and kind of grew that interest in pursuing this?
Yeah, I actually had a funny start to playing football. It was my older brother. I kind of followed in his footsteps pretty much in everything he did. And I remember he started playing football early on. I think I was probably still in first grade, but he was in third grade. And whatever, basically till like second grade, whatever team my brother was on, my parents just put me on that team. So I was playing on a third grade team as a first grader. So I was just getting absolutely tossed around and I was not able to hang with those guys, but I can't say I loved it at first, but over the years, I built a love for football. I loved the contact. I loved the preparation, everything that came with it. So yeah, it was a funny journey, but yeah, up until I would say high school, baseball is my sport, and then football kind of took over after that.
Now, playing up a couple of grades there on your brother's team, did that kind of instill the toughness for you a little bit? Because as you mentioned, getting thrown around by some of those bigger kids.
Yeah, absolutely. There was like literally some times like I could not hang with some of these guys. But I think playing like that like teaches you a little bit of that toughness, teaches you that competitive nature. Because after you keep losing like that, you either have two options. You either quit or you find a way to win. And so like I was kind of forced to find a way to win.
Now, once you got to high school coming out, you were a five-star prospect, one of the highest rated recruits in the country. So I do want to ask though, at what point did you really kind of figure out like, oh, okay, I can take this to that next level. What was that moment for you?
Yeah, my high school journey was also kind of interesting. My freshman year, I was not at all the player I was that I grew to be at the end of high school, but I was third string on our freshman team. So I was on our B team. And so after that, I kind of knew if I really wanted to, you know, achieve my goal of playing college football at a high level, then I'd have to make some changes. So after that kind of off season, I ended up starting. I went from our B team on freshman team to starting varsity our sophomore year. And kind of that season was really filling things out. And I started making some plays and was able to get some tape together. And I think after that off season, when I finally started getting some offers, it became you know, real to me. It was funny. My first offer actually came on a visit. I thought I was there just to go with my brother at the time. I didn't know they were even recruiting me. And then I remember it was at Indiana. Coach Kevin Wilson came up to me and offered me a scholarship. And I was literally like so confused because I thought I was literally just, you know, they were tagging along for my brother.
That's an awesome story because I think it kind of shows the growth that you've been on, as you mentioned, since the start of high school all the way up through your years at Ohio State to now. And obviously some of the time at Ohio State was tough for you with the injuries. But I wonder, looking back now, what maybe you learned from that time when you were away from the game a little bit and you couldn't play this game that you grew to love?
Yeah, that was probably one of the hardest times of my life, especially when I was young dealing with these injuries, because I was just, you know, away from the game for so long, the game that I love so much. And I think the hardest thing was that I saw myself as being here playing at that level. And I was right there because of injuries and some different things. And yeah, that was a really hard time, but how I was able to push through that and, you know, the support of my teammates, coaches and all that, I think that made me that much of a better player, a better person. Better teammate, all of the above.
And you really started to pop on the field during the course of when you were able to come back from those injuries and then go to the Senior Bowl. And you have Senior Bowl director Jim Nagy talking about you as one of the guys that's helped himself the most over the course of the 2 months, including that Senior Bowl trip. So what did it mean for you to hear that kind of recognition from a guy that has been doing this a long time as part of the draft scouting process?
Yeah, that's awesome. It was really cool. I think the whole experience over the last 2 years of where I finally started getting to make some plays definitely didn't come as a surprise to me, because I think that was also a reason why I was able to overcome a lot of those injuries. Because even though when I was not playing or in the, you know, rehab room, I was still had my expectations of, you know, being the best linebacker in the country. And so when those plays started coming, it really didn't come as a surprise for me. But, you know, reflecting back on it, it was, obviously really, really cool experience.
And now you've had the opportunity here to go through the Senior Bowl, as I mentioned, pro days. And I read that you've been talking a little bit back and forth with Luke Kuechly, former Carolina Panthers linebacker who went to the same high school that you did. So what was his biggest piece of advice kind of going through this process?
Really, I think the biggest thing is he told me is just, you know, enjoy it, because, you know, you're never going to be in this position again in your life where you could be pulled 9 different directions. You're living in that state of kind of uncertainty. So, I mean, it was, you know, to hear that from him, it was kind of, you know, everything he says to me, I take it in instantly. And he's a guy that I've seen as a mentor probably since my junior high school. And anything he says to me, I'm constantly listening.
That's a pretty good mentor to have, to say the least, after what he was able to go on and do in his NFL career. And to that point, I do like to ask, you know, who are some of the guys that you look at the linebacker position as you're trying to incorporate more aspects into your game? Because it's a constant development process, especially now for linebackers who are asked to do so much in today's game.
Yeah, I would say the first, I probably watched the most film on Luke Kuechly just because he's so fun to watch. Because if you watch him, he like literally, he's pointing things out before the play that no one else knows. And you can literally see that, you know, happening in real time. And so I think he's probably the most fun to watch. I don't think I play like him. If I had to say someone I played like, I think it'd be maybe Levante David, some Bobby Wagner. So those are some other guys I watch too, just the way they play the game, the aggressive nature they hit with. And yeah.
And those are two guys that not only have that aggressive nature in the run game, but have shown themselves to be strong in the pass game as well, which I think is a huge part of the position today, especially with the way that you're being asked to cover, whether it's linebacker or whether it's tight ends or sometimes wide receivers coming out of the slot. So for you, just what has it been like developing that those skills as well in terms of, you know, having that versatility all around?
Yeah, I think right when I was coming out of high school, you start to see that shift of playing linebacker, because I remember literally in high school, pretty much all of my mentors, a lot of my coaches were like, all right, you're getting ready to go to Ohio State big time football. Like, if you're going to be a linebacker, you probably want to get up, gain some weight, get up to 250 pounds so you can, you know, thud up against some linemen. And then I think right when I got started getting to Ohio State, like the whole mentality shift to where they need linebackers who can play out in space, linebackers who can also fit in the run. And so, yeah, that was interesting development, or hard part of my development early on. And, you know, something I think I've grown to be very comfortable with.
No doubt. And you're continuing to go now towards this NFL draft coming up later this month. And what's the biggest area that you're working on right now? Because as I mentioned, pro days in the past, so you're not necessarily training to run the 40, which is something I know that you don't really ever do any other time other than during the course of this process. So what's the biggest area of the game you're working on right now?
I think right now the biggest thing is the last 2 years I've pretty much played out in space at the same position. And so I want to be as versatile as possible. So I've been working really hard on, you know, getting back in the field of things and being inside as at the Mike and Will position. And it's pretty similar, but sometimes it's like the eyes and reads of what you're seeing can be a little different. So, I just want to keep working the game, increase my football IQ, and, you know, get back in the flow of things and being inside.
No doubt. And as you continue now to build towards the NFL, just what would you say to any team that's looking to draft you that you bring to the table?
I think first and foremost is, you know, the way I play the game. I think the first thing I usually try to tell scouts and coaches is that it's probably going to be nearly impossible to find any play that I'm on film where I took off or I'm not, you know, aggressively running to the ball. So I think the biggest part of my game and why I was able to make so many plays is the way I pursue the ball and the way I play the game. And I think, you know, scouts were able to see that and coaches were able to see that on film.
Now, the final question that I have for you, and I know you'll be happy to be drafted by any team that calls your name during the course of that weekend, but as a Cincinnati guy, who was the team for you growing up? Who was your team that you backed the most?
I'm a little torn on this because, I mean, I was actually born in Cleveland. I have a family full of Browns fans, but for the majority of my life, I lived in Cincinnati. So yeah, I want to say a mix between both, but that doesn't even sound right. So I have to go with one, probably the Bengals.
Okay. I was going to say it's kind of tough because they're both in the AFC North there, and that rivalry probably a little bit more difficult to say, you know, fan of both. But exactly. Justin, I really appreciate the time, man. It's been a lot of fun. Good luck to you throughout the rest of this process, and can't wait to see what you do in the NFL. All right.
Awesome. Thanks, man.